Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asian Line and have a top stories. We are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 24th of July. Opposition protests against India's union budget calls it discriminatory. 18 dead, pilot injured in plane crash during takeoff in Nepal. And Bangladesh partially restores telecommunication services as protests take off. And now for all the details, the opposition lawmakers on Wednesday staged a protest inside and outside the Indian Parliament against the union budget presented by Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman and called it a discriminatory against non-National Democratic Alliance states. The budget announced that Andhra Pradesh and Bihar would get significant funds. The opposition lawmakers briefly disrupted the Lok Sabha, demanding time from the Speaker to have a discussion over the matter. Congress President Mallikarjun Kharge, while speaking to reporters, said that the budget is anti-people and nobody has got justice. Taking jibe at the ruling BJP, Samajwadi Party Chief Akhilesh Yadav said the budget is focused on giving a support price to NDA alliance partners to save the government.
ये बजट जनविरोधी है, अन्याय है, किसी को भी न्याय मिला नहीं, बिहार को खुद सड़क को बनते हैं, सड़क के लिए पैसे दिए, ये कोई बड़ी बात है, वो यहाँ स्पेशल पैकेज बोल रहे हैं, लेकिन स्पेशल स्टेटस आंध्र को भी नहीं है, ये सब एक ये डिसिप्टिव बजट है और इसमें अन्याय है।
इस बजट से दिखाई दे रहा है कि सरकार कितनी कमजोर है। हम सब लोग तो किसान के लिए उसका समर्थन मूल्य मांग रहे थे, हम लोग किसान के लिए पैकेज मांगते हैं, गरीब के लिए पैकेज मांगते हैं, लेकिन ये सरकार देखिए आप किसको पैकेज दे रही है। जो सरकार चलवा रहे हैं, सरकार चलाने के लिए पैकेज मिल रहा है, बिहार को पैकेज मिला, आंध्र प्रदेश को पैकेज मिला। हम ये नहीं कहते कि पैकेज नहीं मिलना चाहिए, डेवलपमेंट के लिए, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर के लिए पैसा मिले, लेकिन दूसरे प्रदेशों के साथ भी भेदभाव न हो।
However, Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman lashed out at Kharge's claim regarding the budget and said that it was an outrageous allegation and a deliberate attempt by the opposition to give the people the wrong impression. She said that the Congress party has been in power for a very long time in this country and they have presented so many budgets that they would know clearly that in every budget, you don't get an opportunity to name every state of this country. This budget marks the first under Prime Minister Narendra Modi's third term in office. A terrorist was neutralized in an encounter by security forces in Kupwara district of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Wednesday. According to a statement by Army Srinagar Corps, a joint operation was launched on Tuesday based on input regarding presence of terrorists in General Area Code of Kupwara. Suspicious movement was observed and challenged by vigilant troops, in response to which terrorists opened indiscriminate fire, the statement said, adding that one soldier identified as Nayak Dilwar Khan, who was injured in the operation, succumbed to his injuries. Meanwhile, in a separate incident, the Indian Army foiled an infiltration attempt along the line of control in Jammu and Kashmir's Battal sector in early hours of Tuesday. In a tweet, the White Knight Corps had said troops foiled the infiltration bid by effectively engaging infiltrating terrorists with effective fire. One soldier identified as Lance Naik Subhash Chandar was killed in action during the operation. Moving on, activist Amjad Ayub Mirza has blamed Pakistan has once again started using the Hurriyat conference to demean India's image and give legitimacy to terror attacks in Jammu and Kashmir. A report.
Kashmiri activist Amjad Ayub Mirza has exposed Pakistan's hypocrisy as it orchestrates terror attacks in India's Jammu and Kashmir and uses organizations like the Hurriyat conference for anti-India propaganda while diverting attention from the critical condition in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir. He said the recent All Parties Hurriyat Conference in Lahore was a way of giving legitimacy to the attacks in India by Pakistan-based terrorists. He said this all comes while a civil disobedience movement is underway in POJK, which is stripped of even basic amenities.
So Pakistan has imposed illegal and unjust taxes on the people of Pakistani-occupied Jammu and Kashmir. There is no electricity, there is no flour, there is a crisis of wheat because they have cut the subsidies. The population has grown and the allocation of wheat and flour to various places inside POJK has not been revised. So there is a crisis of democracy, there is a crisis of economic rights, there is a crisis of ownership of resources in POJK.
The activist further blamed it is the Hurriyat Conference that has promoted communal politics and terrorism in India's Jammu and Kashmir as part of its so-called freedom movement.
Since 9th of June, when Prime Minister Narendra Modi took oath for the third time as Prime Minister, to choose that day to attack yatris, pilgrims, Hindu pilgrims in Jammu, is the beginning of a new era of violence and terrorism in Jammu and Kashmir, sponsored by Pakistan. And Hurriyat Conference is now again back in the game in Pakistan to divert the attention of the international media from these attacks, number one, and number two, to give legitimacy to these attacks that are taking place in Jammu and project them as some kind of freedom movement. Whereas these are terrorist attacks that have only one point agenda, to sabotage the elections.
In a horrific incident, at least 18 people lost their lives in a plane crash as it caught fire on Wednesday during a takeoff in Nepal's Kathmandu. While the pilot was rescued and had been rushed to hospital till the last reports came in. Officials said that the plane was carrying two crew members and 17 technicians to Pokhara City to repair another aircraft. The firefighters rushed to the site and put out the blaze. Reports suggest the plane flew a little above the runway and then tilted before it crashed. The plane belonged to local Shaurya Airlines and was almost 20 years old. Nepal has been criticized for a poor air safety record and nearly 350 people have died in plane or helicopter crashes in the Himalayan country since the year 2000. Most recently, at least 72 people were killed in a Yeti Airlines crash in January 2023 that was later attributed to the pilots mistakenly cutting off power.
Bena sunne bhanne ni hamle pratishyaka live dekheko ho jastai hami yani ra basirathi kaam garera tyani ra chai euta awaz aayo hamle ke sochhe bhane euta ke thokeko hola tyre padgeyo hola bhanne hamle tyo feel garyau ani feri ekchin pachi aundha khari chai प्लेन ग्रस्त भएको रहेछ भन्ने मतलब त्यो कन्टेनर एउटा माथिपट्टि थियो कन्टेनरमा भएको भएदेखि त सायद यो हामी भन्ने ठाउँमै आएर ब्लास्ट हुन्थ्यो होला त्यो कन्टेनरले हामीलाई बचायो त्यो कन्टेनर ठोकेर चाहिँ अनि त्यसपछि चाहिँ प्लस आगो बल्दै आएर यहाँनिर चाहिँ ब्लास्ट भयो.
Bangladesh partially restored telecommunication services on Wednesday, days after a deadly protest against reservations for government jobs killed almost 150 people. While mobile services were restored, internet connection was reported to be slow and social media remained suspended in the South Asian nation. The country has mostly been calm since Sunday when the Supreme Court scaled down reservations for various categories to 7%, overruling a High Court verdict reinstating a 56% quota in government jobs that had been scrapped in 2018. Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina's government said on Tuesday that it would heed the Supreme Court ruling. Protesting students have, however, given the government a fresh 48-hour ultimatum to fulfill four other conditions of an 8-point list of demands and said they will announce next steps once that ends on Thursday. The country was rocked by protests since the High Court verdict last month, which left less than half of the state jobs open on merit in a country where about 32 million young people are out of work or education. The protest intensified after Hasina refused to meet the protesters' demands. Earlier this week, the government had blamed opposition parties for the violence. The Central Bank of Sri Lanka cut interest rates by 25 basis points on Wednesday in a surprise decision aimed at helping fuel the island nation's economic recovery from its worst financial crisis in decades. It said it took the decision in the absence of significant inflationary pressure and that it expects inflation to remain below its 5% target in the medium term. Inflation dropped to 1.7% in June, a sharp contrast to 70% in September 2022 during the height of the financial crisis. Sri Lanka cut power tariffs by 22.5% and reduced fuel and cooking gas prices this month to reduce living cost. However, the latest rate reduction is unlikely to propel growth beyond the projected 3%, with markets likely to keep a close eye on Sri Lanka's upcoming presidential elections, which are expected to be held before mid-October. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.